And now it is time for the news, read tonight by Cass Stevens, who also wrote it. Good evening. Lady Margaret Thatched-Roof sent a memo to Downing Street today saying, the lady is not for burning. David Cameron, bemused by the memo, amidst expecting Lady Thatched-Roof to arrive for her 85th birthday bash, decided to telephone Lady Thatched-Roof to ask what the memo meant. Lady Thatched-Roof was unable to take the call personally, so her slave, Connie Char, took the call instead, and it transpired that Lady Thatched-Roof was not going to make her birthday bash, since a spin doctor had leaked to her that the birthday bash was being held with a hidden agenda. The Old Boy Blue Network, who once served under Lady Thatched-Roof, have long since grown tired of having to attend these infamously tedious birthday bashes, since it prevents them from having more fun elsewhere, like playing the stand-in roles for the lead characters in the TV sitcom Last of the Summer Wine, filmed on location in Holmfirth, West Yorkshire. Sir Bernard Ingham apparently stands in as Compo, the scruffy, bedraggled, tramp-like character, whilst Lord Norman Tebbit stands in as Norman Clegg and Lord Howe as Foggy. With a dastardly plan afoot, the three Last of the Summer Wine stand-ins akin to the Old Boys in Thatched Roof Blue Network, were ready to give Lady Thatched Roof a very warm birthday bash. Their plot being to place Lady Thatched Roof on the top of a giant birthday cake and light the huge altar candles all around her, making sure that she had the send-up of her life. Lady Thatched Roof, however, was tipped off that the dastardly plot was afoot, and to ensure that she joined her late husband Dennis the Menace Thatched Roof in the great gig in the sky. In the light of this, she decided that because of having chipped her rather large ironclad dentures following their nuclear fallout on her kitchen floor, making them as unsightly as herself, that she would send a polite memo to David Cameron excusing herself for another round of flatulence. David Cameron tried hard to persuade Lady Thatched-Roof via her faithful slave Connie Char to still attend, even offering to buy her a new set of dentures on the National Health Service. But Lady Thatched-Roof really was not for burning. It is hoped that the Old Boy Blue Network will come up with a new dastardly plot to relieve the party faithful of the Iron Lady, who since winning custody of her teeth has driven them all mad amidst her endless chatter. Connie Char secretly admitted to David Cameron that she is deliberately scared Lady Thatched-Roof by creeping up behind her in the kitchen and striking a match at close range at Lady Thatched-Roof's head, in the hope that her dentures would fall out, in order to give her a much-needed break from the endless chunnering from Lady Thatched-Roof, not to mention the endless marching orders dished out from daybreak to bedtime, which apparently is extremely tedious. She went on to apologise to David Cameron and the Old Boy Blue Network for thwarting their plans to relieve everyone of the Lady Thatched-Roof permanently. Connie Char seemed very distressed that she had thwarted this. David Cameron has conveyed the message from Connie Char to the Old Boy Blue Network. Meanwhile, Lady Thatched-Roof's dentures have been taken to the Camel Laird shipyard for repair, and the Iron Lady is having to make do with a packet of fruit gums to exercise her motorised mouth. Connie Char says she's enjoying the much-needed blissful peace and quiet. We shall, of course, keep you abreast of the plotting by the Old Boy Blue Network. More news later. Watch this space, minus Lady Motormouth Thatched Roof.